Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Our today's topic is tooth numbering system. So first of all, what are the questions that are asked from tooth numbering system? It can be asked as a short answer question for 5 marks. Okay, now how to write this answer when this is asked as a short answer question? So first of all, you need to tell about the introduction would include first what is tooth numbering system, that is the definition of tooth numbering system. Second, why there is a need for a tooth numbering system. Then third would be what are the various systems or what are the various tooth numbering systems. Okay, and then you need to explain all the systems. So this is how you need to present this answer. Okay, so to begin with, first of all, what is tooth numbering system? It is a system used by dentist to associate information to specific tooth. So dentist use this system to associate information to specific tooth. Okay, so this is a system used by dentist to associate information to specific tooth. Now what is the need for this system? Kyun hame chahiye tooth numbering system? First of all, it is for easy communication. Then in clinical practice, it is very important to have a shorthand system for recording data. ठीक है, so it is very important in clinical practice to have a shorthand system to record data, and then there should be uniformity in the numbering of tooth all over the world for consistency and then for specificity. So this is why we need tooth numbering system, for easy communication. A shorthand system should be there for clinical practice to record the data. There should be uniformity, consistency and specificity. Now what are the various tooth numbering systems that have been given? So there are numerous tooth numbering systems that have been given by different scientists, and different notations are given to different tooth, but the most widely accepted and most what we can say, the most popular systems are three, which is universal, Palmer or Zsigmondy system, and then FDI system. Okay, so first of all, let us see what is universal system. So in universal system, it was, first of all, it was given by Paradit in the year 1882 and by Cunningham in the year 1883. So this system is officially used in USA. Okay, and it was accepted by ADA in the year 1968. So in the year 1968, this system was accepted by or adopted by ADA. Now what is this system? How is this explained? Let us see. So see, for permanent dentition, it gives Arabic numbers to permanent dentition, which is from 1 to 32. And it gives alphabets to the deciduous dentition, which is from A to T. After appointing these alphabets, we need to move clockwise across the dentition, okay? We need to move clockwise across the dentition after appointing Arabic or alphabetical numbers. Now, how is it done? See, first of all, the complete jaw, it is divided into four quadrants, okay? This would be maxilla or the upper quadrant. This is mandible or the lower quadrant. This is right side and this is the left side. So we would start from maxillary or upper right side, and the numbers here are given in permanent 1 to 8, then here 9 to 16, here 24 to 17, matlab 17 to 24, it would start clockwise. So 8 to 9, 16 se 17, yaha 24 se, here 25 to 32. Okay, so this is what? This is in permanent dentition, and in deciduous dentition it is given like A se leke numbering. Theek hai? So see here, this is what permanent dentition, and this one is the deciduous dentition. In permanent dentition, how we would number it would start from third molar, maxillary upper right quadrant third molar. So this would be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16. Then it would start again from the third molar. So this is 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 23, 24, 25, 26, and so on till 32. Remember one thing, if this maxillary third molar, even if this is missing, then also we need to number the second molar would be number 2. It won't be number 1. Okay, even if any teeth is missing or if any teeth is removed, then also the adjacent teeth would be appointed the same number. Jo wo missing na ho tab appoint kar rahe hain. So if for example third molar is missing, then also the adjacent second molar would be given number 2 and it would not be given number 1. Okay, so this is in permanent dentition. Then in deciduous, how is it numbered? It is numbered from A. So this is A, B, C is canine, D, E is central. Then here the maxillary left central, first central incisor would be F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S and T. So this is the numbering in permanent from 1 to 32, and then we need to move in the clockwise direction. And this is the numbering in deciduous from A to T, moving in a clockwise direction. Okay, so since this system is not accepted everywhere and other systems are also given, so it is obvious that this system must be having some drawbacks and some advantages. So I told you that this is universally accepted in USA. So there must be some advantages of this system, and this is not accepted everywhere. So there must be some disadvantages jiski wajah se dusra system aaya. So what do you think are the advantages? First of all, specific number. Dekho, har teeth ka ek specific number is given to every teeth. Okay, so what happens is this reduces the chances of any mistake that could occur. Second, what is the advantage? It is easy to visualize. Okay, but there are certain disadvantages of the system because of which new systems are given. So what are the disadvantages? First is that it cannot be coded by computer. Okay, So first disadvantage is it cannot be coded by computer, and second is it is difficult to remember. Obviously, if all of a sudden someone says you 27, you won't be able to remember that what is 27. So it is difficult to remember and it is also confusing. Okay, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of this system. So after that, the next system is Palmer or Zsigmondy system. Okay, so this system was given by Adolf Zsigmondy in the year 1861, and it was given individually by Palmer. Dono ne alag alag diya tha. So it was given by Palmer in the year 1870, and they gave it for the permanent dentition, but it was modified by scientist for primary dentition also. Okay, so what happens in this system? See, first of all, this system is also known as, what is its synonym? It is also known as four quadrant symbolic system. Okay, so this system is also known as four quadrant symbolic system. Here the arches, they are divided into four quadrants. Okay, this is the first, second, third and fourth quadrant. For deciduous dentition, each quadrant is numbered from A to E. See, this would be A to E, this is A to E, here it is A to E, and here also A to E. So for deciduous it is numbered A to E, whereas for permanent it is numbered 1 to 8 everywhere. Okay, so this is the Palmer system. Now how is it numbered? Here the central incisor would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here also it is 1, 2, 8. And in deciduous, how is it numbered? It is numbered A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so this is the way how is it numbered. Now how we will identify ki kaun se side ka A hai ya fir kaun sa 1 hai. So for that, what is done is, like if it is written like this A, we have made quadrant like this and they have taken this angle. So this A means it is maxillary, because upar likha hai, this side upper, so it is maxillary. It is dividing it and it is written on the left side. So left, since it is A, it is deciduous, maxillary left, central incisor. Okay, now tell me if it is C, if it is written like this, what is it? Since it is on the lower side and C is written, first of all 6 hai, so it is permanent. Written on lower side, so mandibular. Then written on the right side, right. Since it is 6th, it is first molar. Okay, so this is how it is identified, by giving these line angles, these lines, or you can say blocks like this. Okay, Now, there are certain advantages and disadvantages of this system also. So, what is the, first of all, what is the advantage of this system? Okay, so advantage and disadvantage of this system. So, what is the advantage of this system? It is simple to use. It is simple to use. It is easy for beginners. There is differentiation between permanent and primary dentition. So, and also it is less confusing. Okay, so these are the advantages. Now, what are the disadvantages of this system? First of all, see here what they are doing is they are making crosses or angles, right? So it is difficult for computer input. Keyboard notation nahi ho payega iska. Then second is that, see, keyboard notation इसका नहीं हो सकता, computer में इसको input नहीं कर सकते. उसके बाद इसमें right upper, right lower, left upper and left lower के बीच में differentiation easily नहीं हो सकता, ठीक है? It is quite typical. There is no provision for supernumerary teeth. This is the third disadvantage, that there is no provision for the supernumerary teeth. And what is the fourth disadvantage? Ki verbally communicate nahi ho sakta. You cannot say, like in verbal communication, you would say only A. So it is very difficult to tell which side of A you are talking about. Okay? So it is very difficult to differentiate between these verbally. So these are the disadvantages of this system. Now, what is the next system? It is the FDI system. So, this system, FDI system, it is also known as two digit system, okay? It is also known as two digit system. This is widely accepted by WHO, by International Association of Dental Research, and it was given by FDI, which is Federation Dentaire International. Okay, so this is a two-digit system. What is happening in the system is they are dividing the quadrant. In permanent dentition, it is numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4. And for primary, it is numbered as 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? So, charo quadrant ko number de diye. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, the teeth, they would be numbered as 1. See, if it is first, second quadrant ka first tooth, which is central incisor, it is 2-1, second teeth is 2-2, then 2-3, 2-4, 2-5 and till 2-8. See, it is not pronounced as 21, 22, 23, it is pronounced as 2-1. So 2-1 means second quadrant, first tooth, that is central incisor. 2-4, it is second quadrant, fourth tooth, which is first premolar. Now, since it is 2, it denotes that it is maxillary, right? Maxillary left quadrant, okay? This is right quadrant and this is left quadrant. So, second is maxillary left quadrant. So, this is how it is numbered. And same for this primary dentition. It is like 6-1, 6-2 till 6-5. So, 6-1 is what? Maxillary left central incisor, which is deciduous. 6-5 is deciduous maxillary left second molar. Okay, so this is how in FDI system, numbering is done. So, okay, so in permanent dentition, it is 21, say 28. This one is 11 to 18. Here it is 31 to 38, and here it is 41 to 48. This is how numbering is done for the FDI system. Now, what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages of this system? Okay, so first of all, advantages. It is simple, accurate, and easy to memorize. Okay, it is simple, accurate, and easy to memorize. So it is user friendly. इसमें क्योंकि नंबर के साथ साथ ही क्वाड्रेंट है तो इसमें एरर्स कम होंगे. सो दे कुड बी इजीली कंप्यूटर इनपुट हो सकता है इसका. एंड इट इज ऑल्सो कम्युनिकेबल. वाई इज इट कम्युनिकेबल? क्योंकि इसमें नंबर के साथ क्वाड्रेंट भी है, साइड भी बताएगा ये, एंड ये टूथ भी बताएगा कौन सा टूथ है. And always remember, the quadrant denotation is written on the left side, and then the tooth number is written on the See, if you write 15, but you need to denote the tooth this one, तो ये गलत हो जाएगा. Okay? तो पहले हम लोग को quadrant number लिखना है, उसके बाद tooth number लिखना है right side में. Now, what are the disadvantages of this system? इट इज़ अब देखो, अगर बहुत सारे टीथ हैं, मल्टीपल टीथ हैं, ठीक है, तो मल्टीपल टीथ में इट इज़ डिफ़िकल्ट टू एंटर. एंड नेक्स्ट, इट इज़ टू लॉन्ग फॉर डेली रूटीन. अब डेली रूटीन में कोई पेशेंट आया है तो आप बैठ के एक नंबर वहाँ पे एंटर नहीं कर सकते हो ना. सो इट इज़ टू लॉन्ग फॉर डेली रूटीन. दिस इज़ इट अबाउट द FDI सिस्टम. ओके, so the next system was given by Victor Hederup of Denmark in the year 1891. Okay, so this system was given by Victor Hederup of Denmark in the year 1891. So this is a variant of 8 quadrant system. Here what they are doing, plus and minus. Plus and minus symbols are used to differentiate between upper and lower and right and left. ये दोनों को differentiate करने के लिए plus and minus sign use करते हैं. Okay? अब how to differentiate या कैसे ये differentiation होता है? Like if it is plus 6, okay? So plus 6 means what? It is upper left first molar. Now why is it upper? Because plus hai. So plus is upper and minus is lower. So plus 6 upper hai kyunki ye plus hai. Then why is it left? It is left because jo tooth number hai wo left mein likha hai, aur ye tooth number se pata chalta hai ki ye first molar hai. Ab agar maan lo 6 minus hai, माइनस है इसका मतलब ये लोअर है. अब नंबर जो है वो राइट साइड में लिखा है, इसका मतलब ये राइट है. नंबर है 6, इसका मतलब इट इज़ फर्स्ट मोलर. ओके, सो दिस इज़ हाउ डिनोशन इज डन फॉर द परमानेंट टीथ. नाउ फॉर प्राइमरी टीथ. फॉर प्राइमरी टीथ व्हाट वाज डन वाज it was numbered from 01 to 05. Okay, so it is plus 01 to plus 05 for right. Then it is minus 01 to minus 05. This is for lower left. Okay, this is upper right. Now see how is it done. First of all, deciduous. This is the left side, this is the right side. Upper it is plus, for lower it is minus. Upper plus, lower minus. Okay, now for upper right, right mein to number we have to write on the right side. So it is 1 plus, 0 1 plus se leke 0 5 plus. Lower upper left ke liye it would be 0 1 plus. See, then plus 0 5. Plus pehle aayega. और नंबर इसमें लेफ्ट साइड, इसमें नंबर राइट साइड लिखा रहा है. अब यहाँ पे होगा माइनस, तो ये हो जाएगा 01 माइनस, ये हो जाएगा माइनस 01. इस साइड फॉर परमानेंट ये कैसे होगा, दिस वुड बी प्लस 2 से लेके प्लस 1 से लेके प्लस 8 तक, ठीक है. एंड हियर फॉर द राइट क्वाड्रेंट इट वुड बी 1 प्लस से लेके 8 प्लस, ओके. सो दिस इज हाउ द नंबरिंग इज डन फॉर विक्टर हेडरप. विक्टर हेडरप ऑफ डेनमार्क इन 1891 ही गेव दिस सिस्टम. इट वॉज जस्ट अ वेरियंट ऑफ द 8 क्वाड्रेंट सिस्टम, ओके. सो दीज आर द 4 टूथ नंबरिंग सिस्टम्स विच यू नीड टू मेंशन व्हेन दिस क्वेश्चन कम्स इन द एग्जाम. Once again, let us revise in the universal system how the numbering is done. For the universal system, see, for the universal system the numbering is given from 1 to 8 and so on till 32, ठीक है. And in deciduous में कैसे है, A से लेके T तक. This is the universal system. Then the Palmer or Zsigmondy system. Palmer or Zsigmondy system में क्या किया, 1 से 8 हर quadrant में, and deciduous के लिए it is from A to E. Okay? This is the Palmer or the Zsigmondy system. Then in FDI they have first numbered the quadrant. Okay, and then it is 1 1 say 1 8, and it is from 2 1 to 2 8, from 3 1 to 3 8, from 4 1 to 4 8, and here it is still 6 5 6 1 to 7 1 to 7 5. So this is the FDI system. Victor Hedderup ने plus और minus sign का use किया था एंड उसके अकॉर्डिंग उसने नंबरिंग किया था. प्लस वॉज फॉर अपर, माइनस वॉज फॉर लोअर. एंड सी, जिस साइड नंबर लिखा है वो उसका राइट और लेफ्ट बताएगा. सो इफ इट इज़ प्लस 1 इट मीन्स इट इज अपर, इट इज़ रिटन ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड, लेफ्ट इट इज 1, सो अपर लेफ्ट परमानेंट सेंट्रल इंसाइजर. इफ इट इज़ प्लस 0 1 then it is upper left deciduous or primary central incisor. So this is it about the tooth numbering system and their advantages and disadvantages. I hope I have made myself clear. Thank you. Keep visiting.